So we seem to have reached the magic number of 89. Very good number. It's quite inspiring, isn't it, to imagine 89 people from all over the world coming together for this. Each one of us prioritizing meditation and the practice of the Dhamma to deepen our understanding of the Buddha's teachings and to apply them in our lives. It's really something very precious and very special. And I'm sure all of you feel like beginners and feel like you keep making mistakes and you're not going that deep. But my goodness, compared to the direction of the world, you know, the way that most people are going in, it's really something quite extraordinary to prioritize peace. So I'd like to give a little guided meditation now for about 45 minutes or so. And there'll be a break before the next sutta class, which Ajahn Brahm will lead. So remembering that whatever's offered here, whatever suggestions or advice is given, it's all just invitations to explore your own mind. So if something resonates for you, you may want to pick that up and try and practice with it. There's no right or wrong. But if that feels not very appropriate or relevant to your experience right now, then please just carry on meditating in a way that best suits you and best suits the condition of your mind in this moment, because it's always going to be different at any time of day, depending on your health, depending on the presence or absence of the hindrances. Something different might be needed. So I'll just lead it along the lines of becoming present with kindness and see which direction it goes in for you. So please get yourself comfortable. I'm very encouraged to see some of you are still drinking your tea. I'm always late with my tea, so I'm going to take one more sip. And with your eyes closed, coming in contact with the feeling world. So as soon as our eyes are closed, there's far less stimulation for the mind, for the senses. And we can turn our inner eye into the realm of sensations in the body. Things that it's hard to name, but things which can be felt. And just checking, first of all, whether your body is really comfortable. Sometimes we sit in postures that have worked in the past. Maybe automatically, without really checking into our body and asking the body what the body needs now. So as you pass your awareness through the body, notice if anything is slightly crunched or ankles are pressing into the shins, whether your weight is evenly distributed between your two buttocks, whether your legs are crossed loosely or tightly, in the position of your spine, even want to rock a little bit backwards and forwards, just sensing the position of your spine in relation to the buttocks, the thighs, to see where it feels most balanced. Perhaps rolling the shoulders back. Often there's a lot of tension in the shoulders and the neck. You move your your shoulders and come all to the position of your arms. So you may want to adjust your hands, your arms. And then perhaps gently moving the neck backwards and forward, slowly until you find the optimum position for your head. Breathing in, slightly long breath, breathing out, relaxing more deeply. Allowing any tensions to gently melt away. I'd like to start by reminding us all that we're in the presence, the company of good friends. And how special it is to be alone and yet surrounded by a sense of friendship and warmth. Recognizing that although we all come from different places, we're sitting in different parts of the globe, we all have our struggles, we all have our joys, very similar to one another. Some of us may be feeling healthy, bright, energized. For others, it may be a time of sickness, exhaustion, anxiety, or even despair. All different weathers, different seasons of life that we all experience in due course. But everything, everybody belongs. Just as you are. Just as the nature manifests at this moment for you. Perhaps imagining, if it helps for you, that you're in the presence of a benevolent teacher, perhaps a Buddha, someone you really look up to, a benevolent friend or benefactor, or even perhaps a beautiful, warm, sacred space in nature, perhaps even in your own home, somewhere that you really feel content, safe, and accepted fully who you are. Imagine now that you're being regarded with such kindness, such love. Way that a Buddha would regard you. And see if you can relax in that gaze of unconditional care. imagining that gaze, that unconditional kindness now turning inward into your body. Starting from the top of the head, as though you were basking in the warm sunshine. And as that sunshine spreads across the top of your head, you become aware of the sensations there, perhaps tingling sensation, maybe throbbing. Perhaps tension or tightness. And as you become aware of those sensations, the sunshine also infuses them with warmth, with kindness and care. Spreading this kind awareness, the light and the warmth of the sun across your forehead, your temples, eyebrows, eyes, and cheeks. Noticing any sensations in these areas and just allowing them to relax. Perhaps spending a little bit longer on your brow. Perhaps the jaw. Areas that we tend to hold tension. Defensive response to the world. Now sitting in this benevolence. In the warm sunshine. Feeling safe. Feeling relaxed, we can allow all that defensiveness to just drop away. The jaw to soften. The whole head to relax. Noticing the back of the head, the ears, the throat. Allowing this warmth of the sun to spread across the shoulders and down the arms. Just receiving any sensations that manifest in those areas for you. If you don't feel anything, that's fine. Just stay present, stay quiet. Soon, the eyes of the mind may start to notice. energy, maybe tingling, some sensation. Tells you this is my arm, my hand, fingers, fingertips. And spreading this warm, kind awareness across your chest, the whole front of your torso. Without any effort, just as though you're basking in a very gentle, warm morning sun. Sun shines on everything equally, without preference, without resistance. So likewise, your kindfulness shines through and down your whole torso, belly, intestine, pelvis, and the hips, relaxing any tension or tightness. Maybe even healing any imbalance or disease. Noticing any sensations at the top of your back, across the back of the shoulders. Not forgetting the armpits or the sides of the ribs. Allowing that kindfulness to penetrate right through your torso, leaving no part untouched. Right down to the waist, back of the buttocks, and the seat of the trunk. Lingering in any areas that may feel more intense, tight or contracted. Just imagining bathing these areas in this beautiful golden sunshine, kindness and mindfulness together, light and the warmth of the sun. Just caring for the sake of caring, without agendas, without trying to push anything away. And the sunshine now illuminates your thighs, bathing them too in a golden glow, relaxing any tightness in the muscles, joints. Any aches or tensions in the knees starts to melt away. As if those tensions, that tightness is absorbed into the ground, leaving your body lighter. More relaxed than at peace. Receiving any sensations in your shins, calves, ankles, maybe areas of warmth behind the knees. Noticing the subtle differences in sensations as you gently receive the sensations in the legs, the ankles, and right down to the feet. Allowing the feet to fully relax. And experiencing sensations right down to the tips of the toes. Now it works for you. Noticing the whole body. So the whole body was simply basking in a beautiful, gentle sun. Noticing if there are any sensations that particularly stand out, and that call your attention, that ask for a little bit more care. And allow that care to be very gentle. Noticing if you're resisting anything, any experience, and seeing if there's anything you can let go of and lift a bit more. Allowing the relaxation to deepen. As though the body were perhaps lying on a very comfortable armchair. Maybe floating in a turquoise warm lagoon. No holding needed. Everything fully relaxed. Noticing that whatever you experience, you're experiencing now, right in this present moment. Without changing your experience, just see if you can notice the perception of the present. The now-ness of now. That perception that tells you you're here. Right in the center of time. Right in that center of this moment, you may notice there is no noise, no thought. Just staying present, curious, sensitive, and aware. and trust in the silence. Respecting the silence, being kind and gentle, and so soft. Whatever you're aware of, there's no right or wrong. Whether you're still aware of the body, sensations, somewhere in the body. Whether you're aware of thoughts. See if you can keep your awareness right in the center of your experience, right with whatever is arising for you now. Notice your attitude towards it. Whether you could become even softer, even gentler and kinder. The experience of now. How that kindness and gentleness softens the experience, quietens everything down. The more that the mind quietens, the more subtle and refined the objects of your awareness. It takes a refined mind to notice the breathing. Just allow the mind to be soft and gentle. And when it's ready, the breath may come and visit you. There's no need to go out, to move away from this present moment or your present experience in search of the breath. Just stay with kindness right where you are. And if the breath wishes to come, allow it in. If it wishes to go, that's fine too. Breath is not under our control. See that if it does visit you, you treat the breath as a friend with utmost gentleness and respect, so grateful just for this one simple, humble little breath. If in this 1 hour, 45 minutes of meditation, I'm able to watch just one breath. Great kindness and care, without force, without tension. That's already enough. Anything more than that, wow. That's so delightful. Thank you, little breath, for visiting. Please stay as long as you wish. So I'll be quiet now. Please just stay present, making your relationship with whatever arises the focus of your practice. With kindness and gentleness, you can never go wrong. already coming close to the end of this meditation. But if you wish to continue, please carry on. Just enjoying whatever peace whatever happiness you've developed in your mind. And breathing a few more breaths with that feeling of peace and joy. Noticing that the happiness of meditation is a different type, much subtler and more refined than the happiness in the room. It's the joy of letting go, the joy of putting down burdens, of simply being present and kind. Just appreciating whatever is, however few moments of mindfulness you experienced in this session, recognizing what a rare gift, a rare experience that is in this world, and also appreciating the support of all the other meditators here, diligently practicing for themselves and also to support each one of us. Dedicating any peace and joy that we've experienced in this session for the good and benefit of everybody in this retreat. And for the good and benefit of all beings, human beings, animals, spirits, invisible beings that may be around also supporting us all. May all beings be happy. May all beings be peaceful. May all beings be fully liberated. If you wish, you can gently open your eyes. Well, you're welcome to continue.